All right, this is Brother Ishayar coming at you with another lesson. First off, I'm going to give all praises to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rakakwadash. Double honors to the apostles of the great millstone, which I learned is true from. Honors to the elders and brothers out there pushing his word through the four corners of the earth within truth and sincerity. And shalom to the Akwath that's listening and learning. So like you. Today's video is going to be entitled, Don't Let the Lust Demon Crush You. It's just going to be a quick lesson, you know, nothing, you know, too major or anything like that. But I just felt like I needed to speak on this because of, you know, past experiences of being within his truth and just dealing with women in period. Because at the end of the day, we all know that we're at the finish line of this thing. We're getting close to the finish line, I should say. You know, it's a lot of things that's happening within the world, and we can definitely see that the end is near, man. We can definitely see that Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, you know, is getting ready to make that major move, and the hour of temptation is coming. And one thing that you do not want to happen as far as you falling out this truth is because you were lusting over a woman, all right? Because at the end of the day, man, you know, hey, if you really feel like you need a woman, man, you know, just pray on it. And, you know, Lord willing, Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai will grant you with one. Will bless you with one, I should say. All right? But don't let, you know, a woman take up the majority of your time, you know. Never get to the point where you find yourself, you know, talking to her a lot more than you studying or trying to be a part of this truth. Or, you know, you doing the most extreme things just to see her, or you just doing things that you know that's outside of your character, or you just doing things that you know that a man of the Lord will not do. Because at the end of the day, man, we at the end, this is all we got. So you should not let something as simple as that take you away from this truth, man. Battle those demons, okay? And then, you know, Lord willing, the Most High put the Spirit upon you, just be like, you know what, look, I'm good. I know we at the end. I'll just wait for the kingdom. Or like I said, if you really feel like you need, you know, need a woman, you know, go about it the right way, man. But don't let that be a distraction to you, okay? So let's get, we're going to get a couple of chapters. I might get three, but we'll see. Let's get Sirach real quick. We're going to get Sirach 9 and 2. And it says, give not thy soul unto a woman to set her foot upon thy substance. Meet not with an harlot, lest thou fall into her snares. Snares meaning traps, okay? That's like we just saw with the picture that I just had earlier. It says she's a man eater, you know. Dudes would do the most to try to meet up with a female if he really sees that he's about to get some. Point blank period, man. You know? Another thing that popped in my mind too was you know, Kazakh and Manasseh Zagbah. They were doing a video, they were speaking and everything like that. And, you know, they was talking about how, you know, you should always give the majority of your time or a lot of your time to Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai. And it was like, look, man, you know, if a female came up and she was giving you attention and she pretty much was giving you the go, and you had to travel like an hour or two just to go see her and everything like that, man, you would do it. You'll be like, all right, well, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that just so I can go see her. You know, so at the end of the day, man, you know, a lot of these females will get you caught up, man. You never know what their plan is. You never know what their mindset is at. You know, you got to be circumspect when it comes to certain things, man, because we all know that, you know, a lot of extreme or drastic things could happen to you if you're dealing with the wrong woman, man. And that's the thing. Like I said, I know we all want one. We all need women, you know, but at the end of the day, this is what's important. Okay, so the work that you have put towards the seeing that woman, hey, you could be like, well, I could have been doing this. I could have been doing a video. I could have been reading. I could have been on the highways and the byways. I could have been doing something else, you know, and that's what you're supposed to do. All right, so meet not with the harlot, lest thou fall into her snares. Verse 4, use not much the company of a woman that is a singer, lest thou be taken with her attempts. Gaze not on a man, a maid. That too, Salakia, but you know, that thou fall not by those things that are precious in her. Give not thy soul into harlots, that thou loose not thy inheritance. Look not around about thee in the streets of the city, neither wander thou in the solitary place thereof. Turn away thine eye from a beautiful woman, and look not upon another's beauty. For many have been deceived by the beauty of a woman, for herewith love is kindled as a fire. And that's true. I mean, Yahweh Shah said it himself. He was like, man, you pretty much, when you look upon a woman, you already committing adultery with her, you know? Because of this reason, one of the reasons right here in verse 9, it says, sit not at all with another man's wife, nor sit down with her in thine arms, and spend not thy money with her at the wine, lest thine heart incline unto her, and so through thy desire thou fall into destruction. All right? Because at the end of the day, man, you know, we are in his flesh, and a lot of men can get weak, man. Men can get weak, you know, like I said, because of the beauty of a woman. You know, you see a woman that has beauty, you see a woman that got body, you see a woman, you like the way she speaks, whatever the case may be, man. You know, you're pretty much, you'll try to do the most to get with her. You'll see what she's about, you give her some time or whatever, and that's cool. But then at the end of the day, if she tells you that she's with somebody, or she just had a problem with somebody else or whatever, hey, man, you let that go. It ain't the time or the place for that. Right now, we trying to seek salvation. That's our main goal. You know, the women will come afterwards, man. You know, then it says, spend not thy money with her at the wine. You know, if you realize, you know, that she's with somebody else, or she has problems in this world, you know, not even dealing with men, there's problems where she's speaking or whatever, you listening, you be like, I don't think I want to, you know, get involved with you, because you might get me involved in this, and I really ain't got time for that, you know. And then get away from it. Get away from her, man. You know, when you drink and everything like that, you know, your spirit changes. That's why, you know, when you buy certain liquors or you go to the liquor store, they'll have the beer section, they have the wine section, and then they'll have the section called spirits. Because pretty much, man, that's what it's doing. You know, it's changing you, you know, it's making you merry, it's helping you relax and doing all these other things, right? But at the same time, drink too much of it, hey, you might become a demon. You might have that rage get set upon you. You might be sorrowful, you know, whatever the case may be. You know, those things can happen if you drink too much. And at the same time, you know, your guard will be let down as well. You know, you get some of that liquor in your system and everything like that, and then you run into a woman that's attractive to you, you know, You won't even second guess sometimes. You know, you just be like, you know what? It's okay. I'm going to make sure I keep my eyes open, and I'm going to make sure everything is cool. Next thing you know, you doing something that what? That's going to be your destruction, because you inclined to her for your desire. All right? You don't want to wake up in the morning and then look at what you did last night. And then you look at her. You look at the environment that you in, and then you remember everything that she said. And next thing you know, you like, damn, man, I ain't got time for this, you know. Then what you gonna do? You know what you gonna do? You know, your goal is supposed to be on your How About Shem Yahweh Shah, man. That's the point. Never let, you know, never let your guard down, man. You know, do things, you know, within order. You know, if you, like I said, if you need something, man, you know the law. You know who you can get. You know how to deal with women. You know what you can do. All right. But no, never let it get to the point where you just like, man, you know, it's taking up the majority of my time, you know, because you learned about the truth and how you're supposed to handle women and how many women you can possibly have. Never let that get in the way, man. Especially right now, man. We got the end, man. We seeing more chariots than ever. We seeing these businesses closed down. GameStop just had their major thing where they blocking people from investing in the stocks and everything like that. You know, they ready to roll, man. They ready to get this new world order on. And we already know as soon as they do that, man, and that's the closer for us to get up out of here. So that's our goal, man. That's our priority. It's the kingdom. Not the women, man. You know, like I said, that stuff will come on the other side, man. And then and think of it, it'll be way better too. Because you won't have to, you know, spit game or, you know, sweep her off her feet and do all these other things, man. You know, everything will be in order. You know, you'll have as many women as you want, man. But right now, don't deal with that, man. Let's find you one. Be chill. Or, you know, if you feel like you don't need one, then, hey, that's cool, too. You know, you can be like a eunuch, so to speak. You know, just be like, you know what? I'm just going to be to myself, you know, stay focused or whatever. You know, whatever spirit comes upon you, you know, by all means, you know, follow it. Just don't follow it, like I said, to the point where it's going to lead to your destruction, man. You know? Have a balance within this thing, definitely. Let's get First Ezra. And I might close with this, because like I said, I didn't want to make this too long. You know, it's just something that popped in my head because of, you know, like I said, past experiences. And then, you know, seeing how these other men out here, I'm not saying that other men that's in the truth, but just how men out here, just, you know, how they react to females and everything like that. I just been like, man, you know, just chill out. You know, just chill out, man. It ain't nothing that serious, man. It's 1 Ezra 4:13. It says, then the third who has spoken of women and of the truth, this was the Zerubbabel, began to speak. O you men, it is not the great king nor the multitude of men, neither is it wine that excelleth. Who is it that ruleth them or hath the lordship over them? Are they not women? Women have borne a king and all the people that bear rule by sea and land. Even of them came they, and they nourished them up that planted the vineyards from whence the wine cometh. These also make garments for men. These bring glory unto men, and without women cannot men be. Yeah, and if men have gathered together gold and silver, or any other goodly thing, do they not love a woman which is comely in favor and beauty? And letting all those things go, do they not gape, and even with open mouth fix their eyes fast on her? Have not all men more desire unto her than unto silver or gold or any goodly thing whatsoever? And we see that, you know, I see that, like, you know, you get on social media and everything like that, Facebook, YouTube, and everything like that. They'll have these memes, and then they'll be like, yeah, which one was you want? Was you want 2 weeks with these two females, or was you want a whole year free worth of gas or something like that? You know, they be having these comparisons, like, which one was you pick? Was you pick these two fine females, or would you pick a whole year free worth of gas or whatever? And, you know, it'd be a lot of dudes that'd be like, man, I ain't got no problem paying for gas, man. I'll get those two females 2 weeks straight, and they get to do whatever I want them to do. There's a lot of men out there that think like that. All right, they desire women more than anything else in the world, you know, and it's been proven back and forth, man. That's why we be like, look, when you come to this truth, let's find you one, deal with her, and that's it, man. Deal with her, and that's it. And like I said, if you're not blessed with a woman, so, well, you know, as far as relationship goes, then, you know, like I said, do what you got to do as far as, you know, doing what you got to do. All right. You know what the law is as far as women is concerned. This is verse 20. It says, a man leaving his own father that brought him up and his own country and cleaving unto his wife, he sticketh not to spend his life with his wife and remembereth neither father nor mother nor country. By this also you must know that women have dominion over you. Do you not labor and toil and give and bring all to the woman? Yeah, a man taketh his sword and goeth his way to rob and steal, to sell upon the sea and upon rivers, and looketh upon a lion and goeth in the darkness. And when he has stolen, spoiled, and robbed, he bringeth it to his love. So, yeah, this has definitely been proven, man. It's a certain YouTuber out there named Hot Damn My Rock. He used to speak about certain situations like this all the time. You know, getting in the car, traveling 2-3 hours just for possibility of being with that girl or whatever. That's like it says in the scripture right here. A dude to take his sword. Nowadays, you know, he'll take his gun or he'll do whatever it is. He'll go rob a nigga. He'll go steal from somebody. You know, he'll go face, you know, all kind of dangers and everything like that or whatever, just so he can bring it back to the woman that he feels like is going to give him what he wants at the end of the night, man, or just be with him. All right. He'll go through these great measures just so he can finally reach this love for this certain woman, man. You know, showing you that we'll do the most when it comes to certain females, man. But like I said, this is not the mindset for you to be in right now. Let's continue. Verse 25. It says, wherefore a man loveth his wife better than father or mother. Yeah, many there be that have run out of their wits for women and become servants for their sakes. And we've definitely seen that. I mean, Esau pretty much put you in this position now, you know, because the woman is over the man right now. You know, you have to get on one knee and ask them to be with you. And they have to give you the yes or the no, when it actually shouldn't even be like that. It should be like, yeah, the father looks at a certain man and be like, Leah, he's worthy enough. The father gives his daughter over to the man, or that man sees this woman, then he goes to the father again. Or, you know, if other ways happens, you know, he pays the shackles, whatever it is, man, you know, that's what it's supposed to be. You know, it ain't supposed to be the way it is right now in this society, all right? But at the end of the day, you know, we have become servants for their sakes, you know? You got all these dudes out here that'll be like, man, you know, I'm making all this money or whatever just so I can make sure she look good and I'll make sure I pay all her bills. I do this, I do that. You know, Jake do the most, man. Jake do the most just so he can not even get as much as what he actually deserves from her on a daily basis, which is a damn joke. Verse 27, it says, many also have perished, died, have erred, and sinned for women. Have died, man, doing the most. Doing the most. That is doing the most. You went and risked your own life just for a certain woman. Sin against the Most High just for a certain woman. And now, do you not believe me? Is not the king great in his power? Do not all regions fear to touch him? See? And that's the point, man. Many also have perished, have erred, and sinned for women, you know. And this is, and it still goes on to this day, man. It still goes on to this day. You see all kind of men out here that's doing the most for a woman, man. Because at the end of the day, man, they don't have any nuts, man. I'm just going to say that. They ain't got no balls, man, at all. They don't know how to stand up on their own 2 feet and be a man when it comes to certain situations, man. Like I said, you ain't got to be out here doing the most. You ain't got to be out here, you know, showcasing yourself like, yeah, you know, I rule over you. I'm the man in the relationship. You know, you ain't got to do all that, man. Like I said, when you learn about these scriptures, man, you learn how to conduct yourself. You learn how to speak to certain women. You know how to move along within the society while trying to follow the commandments, statutes, and laws of Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shah. Like I said, man, we are not about to perish and sin against the Most High just because we might see a certain woman or meet a certain woman that's super attractive or something like that. You know, we're not about to do that, man. We're about to follow the commandments of Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shah and build up our spirit so we can keep the faith up during Jacob's trouble, and Lord willing, we could be saved up out of it. All right. That's the mindset we should be in right now. The mindset should not be on, you know, chasing females up and down the streets or whatever, calling them, texting them all damn day and doing the most. Nah, this ain't the time for that. You know, like I said, we're gonna have finally our pleasure, you know, our rest and everything like that in the kingdom. And it's gonna be anything that you have ever seen and felt, man. You know, you're gonna be happy, man. You ain't gonna have to worry about doing the most anymore, man. The Most High is just gonna give you everything that you want, man. The Most High is gonna pamper us, man. He's gonna make sure we always good. All right. So make sure you keep your mind on that, man. Keep your mind on the kingdom, man. So like I said, I just wanted to bring this out because it was just on my mind as far as past experiences and, like I said, seeing other people and everything like that. And I was just like, well, you know, I had to speak on this real quick, you know. So hopefully this was edifying, man. Like I said, keep your eyes on the prize, man, and that's the kingdom. So with that, I'm going to say, call Halayim, Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rakan Kodash, double honesty to the apostles of the great millstone, which I learned is true from. Honors to the elders and brothers out there pushing his word through the four corners of the earth within truth and sincerity. And shalom to the Akwat that's listening and learning. And Yahweh Rat Tazah, I'll be back with another lesson. Keep pushing, Yasharala. Keep pushing. We almost out of here. Shalom.